In this short introduction, I'm going to show you how to scaffold your own yFiles for HTML powered graph drawing web application. We're going to use Visual Studio Code, the yeoman generator, to create a TypeScript powered application using webpack for hot reloading and development. So I assume you already downloaded the yFiles package and unzip the package to a convenient location. So the package contains the library, the tools, the documentation, etc. Next, we're going to create a new directory. So let's just switch to the shell. We're going to create a directory, yFiles test. Let's change into that directory. And next, we're going to use yeoman. If you haven't done so, install yeoman using npm install -g yo or yarn. I did that already. Also, make sure you have installed the yeoman generator specific for yFiles. So that would be npm install -g generator yFiles app. I did this already too. So now I can just go ahead and write yo yFiles app. This will start the yeoman generator, and it will start by asking me for the application name, which I can just accept in this case. Next, it will ask me, the first time I call the generator, it will ask me for the location of the yFiles package. It will remember this, so the second time you won't be needing to do this. So I'm just copying the path to the package, pasting it here. Next, it wants to know where to find the license file. If you have the evaluation version, just hit enter because the default will apply. Next, it will ask us what kind of modules we want to use for loading the yFiles library. We usually recommend local npm modules because they work perfectly with code completion and with all the major tool chains like webpack and the CLI tools. For this example, we are going to use TypeScript, but you could just as well use ECMAScript 6. And the next question is whether to scaffold a project structure for us too. We're going to use this because to make it easy for us to get started. So we're going to create a Visual Studio Code integration sample. And we would like to use npm for downloading webpack and the various tools we require for the webpack serving and for the live reloading, for the hot reloading, and for compiling the application. So it will now scaffold all the required files into the yFiles test application. As you can see, there's a VS Code directory, so we'll be able to just open the directory within Visual Studio Code. And let's wait for it to finish. Takes a few seconds the first time. After that, it will cache the results. The next time it should be much faster. Will now scaffold the application. Once it's done, we can also try it out directly. It will put it into an output folder for us to try. See, the files aren't minimized yet, so it takes a while. Okay, here we go. So let's start Visual Studio Code in the directory. And you'll see that we have the package JSON, which loaded the webpack CLI, and the dev server, as well as the Babel toolchain and the TypeScript loader. And we also see that we are using yFiles as our first dependency. Right now it's loaded from a local system. And there's 4 scripts available, production, dev, and start. And actually there's also the option to run a task, so we can just hit npm start. This will again start the Webpack dev server and open the browser for us. It will now compile the application. Meanwhile, we can take a look at the script sources. So here's the TypeScript file. And it's a simple application that just instantiates the graph component, creates a few, configures the styles, creates a few nodes, and runs an automatic layout. As you can see, we got working code completion. So we can inspect the parameters that we have. We get code completion, and we know what type we can use for the various options. We can create a new node, graph, create node, look at the documentation, read the documentation, see the code examples, copy them, and let's see whether it's already done. No, it takes a while. TypeScript is a bit slower, but now it's almost done. Here we have the graph. So two nodes in the sample application. Let's create another node and give it a different size. So as you can see, if I use the wrong number of arguments, it will complain, rightfully, because layout accepts four arguments for x, y, width, and height. I could also be using this variant where there's x 50, y 50, width 100, and completion, as you can see, works. Height 100, so it's a large node. Just hit Control S, it will recompile, directly reload the application. Yeah, here's the bigger node. Perfect, fine, that's it. So have fun writing your TypeScript application.